Hey bitches, what? Yeah. Yeah. You know what day is. Hey guys, welcome back to Sexy Lesbian Shirt Thursday. Nah, guys. Hey, what's up? Welcome back to Thursday of the Flamboyant 5 Lesbian Shirt Thursday, might I add. Lesbos in the house, rock it out. But anyways, so I do wear a lot of lesbian shirts, as one of my friends has dubbed it, so that I wear a lot of lesbian shirts. Anyways, guys, so welcome back, and you're watching Thursday. My seemingly attractive face, I guess, I don't know. Maybe it's my personality that brings you back every time. I'm not sure. But anyways, so if you're watching these videos in ass backwards format, I'm going to just let you know now. This week on the Flamboyant 5, we have been doing like time traveling. Well, we wish we could, but sadly, we're just saying who we'd rather go back in time to, or like what period in time that we'd rather want to go back to, and who we want to meet if we went back there. So, like, Katie and Robbie and Michaela before me, I believe they all said this. I can't remember, I watched all the videos last night because I like to wait for them to collect up and then watch them all. As I believe from last night, everybody said that we all want to go to every time period and meet somebody from that period. Like, I don't believe a specific person, but a random person that you would just find off of the streets, really. Just anybody. So, I actually want to do that too, but really, if I had to meet somebody specific, I'd actually want to meet Donatello from the four Renaissance masters from the Italian Renaissance period. So, reason being is not just because he's the Purple Ninja Turtle with Raphael and Michelangelo and Leonardo, but because he's really cool. I took an Italian Renaissance class last summer, and I thought it was really amazing when I learned about Donatello, because Donatello is actually a sculptor, and his whole name is Donato de Nicola de Bertolbardi. So it's actually really cool, and pretty much, just after taking my 3D design class over at SCAD and making this bad beastie out of Sculpey, and I think, can I turn him the right way? Yes. After making this bad beastie, I found it quite amazing just to make stuff with your hands, because I didn't even know I could do that. Like, I had never sculpted anything before. So I find it really cool, like the amazing lifelike qualities he gets with this stone. Because he just made all these amazing sculptures and everything, and they look amazing. Like, the cloth draping technique, and okay, the only thing by him that I don't really like is his David, because they all did a David, but I don't really like his David, just because his David looks very womanly and very feminine, but I believe all of them made their Davids based off of a woman. But, well, David and Goliath. So, all of his work is phenomenal and fantastic, and I just love them all. Like, it's amazing. He's, like, these people, and Donatello especially, because he was the master of sculpture, they were all able, and mostly him, he was able to take this cloth, like this stone, and make a person out of it, and just make all of this cloth and everything, and it just looks so lifelike and so real and fantastic. And I'd really just love to meet him, because it's like, wow, that is really inspiring and very cool. So if I could ever time travel back in time, I would definitely want to go meet Donato de Nicola de Bertolbardi, because that's really cool. Like, the Italian Renaissance was just a time period of so much invention and discovery and challenge, really, to find and know about the world. So, as I showed you, I just, with my sculpture of Size, S-Y-Z, I find it very incredible and very amazing. And so, yeah. I can't give you, I cannot give you any links. Oh, let's put the book over there. Hold on. I can't really give you any links to Donatello, but if you want, search him up on Google. You will probably find a lot of information about him. There's a Wikipedia page. There's always a Wikipedia page about everything, so that's why I'm just saying there's a Wikipedia page. But most of my information on everything was gotten from this book, actually. Had to throw that one in there. But in this book, so just to zoom in on the name, in case you want to get this book, because this book covers actually a lot of Italian Renaissance art history and everything. It's a phenomenal book, actually. So that's where I learned all my stuff about Donatello and all the other Italian Renaissance artists. So, sorry to say, but good luck finding your information. Anyways, tune in next week, and you guys are gonna be in for a big treat because, oh, it's fantastic. I can't say anything about it. I want to say something about it. I wanted to like show a little bit about my thing, but can't yet. It's not time. Not time. Not till next Thursday. So, we'll see you guys all back then, and subscribe to the channel if you really like seeing our faces because we are so gorgeous. Sexy beasts. But anyways, sorry for the long video. I don't know, I seem to make long videos on accident. But see you guys next week and have a good weekend. Bye.